So in that sense, SALSA is quite an innovative project because it combines reference regions in Africa and Europe, as you know. And even though there are more reference regions in Europe than in Africa, 25 versus 5, it's still a good participation from Africa. And I think it's been very innovative in looking at a topic that is very well studied in Africa, which is the role of small farms and small food businesses for food and nutrition security, to look at that in Europe, but then make the comparison to what is happening in Africa, where the majority of farms are small farms, that is farms that are smaller than 5 hectares or even smaller than 2 hectares in many contexts. So I think the design itself was already ambitious and innovative. And what we are finding is that there are actually quite a few similarities between the challenges that small farms face in Africa and in Europe. Similarities in the sense the big categories, big themes like access to credit, access to land, access to labor, links to markets and so on. But obviously the nature of those challenges will be very different between countries because the contexts are very different. Now, we only work in 5 reference regions in Africa, which is a very, very small sample, obviously. And so we are working in 5 countries, and within these countries only in relatively small geographic areas. So the findings are not representative for the whole of Africa, but yet they are giving us a bit of a snapshot of what different types of small farming systems look like in different parts of Africa. And I think that has been very useful both for the European partners and for the African partners. For the Europeans, many of the European partners have never really thought about farming systems in Africa and what the challenges and opportunities are for small farms. Indeed, many didn't know that a lot of agricultural production in Africa comes from small farms. And so that has been quite interesting, and to see that the challenges are in some cases quite similar. I think for the African partners, it's been interesting because they probably hear a lot in the press about mechanized agriculture, large-scale agriculture in Europe, and a lot of the photos, videos and so on you see in the media, they portray European agriculture as being very advanced and large-scale. And for them to actually see that there's a quite significant number of small farms in Europe who face some of the same challenges that they face in Africa, but also to see what the opportunities are and how different policy instruments have been able to address these is quite useful and interesting for them.